Greetings to you all. Welcome you all for yet another discussion, Dr. RS and you, Science of Cosmetics and Personal Care Products. We have completed 20 parts each. All the parts I have uploaded in the YouTube, and Dr. Ramesh Suryanarayanan, you can get in the YouTube. And kindly get into part 1, where I have introduced myself to you all and also the objective of what I want to do. So kindly get into part 1, and also if you go in sequence, there is a continuation. You have to understand skin before you understand what is skin moisturization, what is skin pigmentation. So if you go in sequence, it will be helpful to you. Thank you. Thank you for all the support. Right. In today, what we are going to discuss, part 21. Part 21 will be about perfume. Building block, perfume. So, 21 will be perfume. Right. Part 21, perfume building blocks. Now, perfume. Perfume is a mixture of fragrant essential oils or aroma compounds, fixatives and solvents used to give the human body, objects and living spaces an agreeable odor. Right. Now, usually the perfume spray we buy from the market, we also call it perfume. But what we say perfume here is, it is the perfume oil. Perfume oil we get from the perfumery houses to incorporate in the cosmetic product. Maybe it's a cream, it's a shampoo, or even a perfume spray. Right? Perfume spray which we get in the market, it's a product. Actually, perfume is the oil which we get. That's how the industry, personal care industry, perfume is the perfume oil which we get from the industry for incorporation in products, right? So perfume is a building block in the product. That perfume can be used for perfume sprays also, right? So you buy the perfume oil and formulate the perfumes, that spray perfumes, right? So here, that is what I want to clarify you, it's perfume oil. It's a mixture of fragrant essential oils or aroma compounds. See, it can be, what is essential oil? Essential oil is the oil which we obtain from the herbs, right, as such, which gives odor. There is a difference between fixed oil and essential oil. Fixed oil is the vegetable oils like coconut oil, no, sesame oil, gingerly oil, where you put that oil on the paper, it stains the paper and it doesn't go. But essential oils or aromatic compounds, aromatic phytoprinciples that we extract from herbs, that when you put on a paper, it evaporates, right, over a period of time. And that is essential oil. It's different from fixed oils that are vegetable oils. So, fragrant essential oils or all the perfumes we are getting is a natural essential oil combination from the extracted from the plants. No, there are a lot of synthetic compounds that are available now. They are called aroma compounds, right? Synthetic molecules called aroma compounds that are blended. So cheap perfumes contains only aroma compounds, and expensive perfumes, very very expensive perfumes might contain only essential oils, right? But usually it's a blend of aroma compounds and essential oils. That is the common perfume. It has a fixative, it has solvents. No, you have a solvent to make that make up that perfume oil which has been submitted for the customer to put it in the product, final product. Perfumery company makes it. Give the human body, objects and living spaces an agreeable odor. You can formulate into products that delivers this, right? Now, a flavor, see, we will discuss more on the perfume today, okay? Flavor is a quality of something that affects the sense of taste. Flavor associated with food, okay? Perfume is associated with something which we apply externally. Flavor is associated with something which is taken internally. Only flavors in personal care used in products like toothpaste and mouthwashes. Right? Toothpaste and mouthwashes, we don't say toothpaste perfume or mouthwash perfume. We say toothpaste flavor and mouthwash flavor. And we say cream perfume, a perfume for cream, perfume for shampoo, perfume for hair oil, or perfume for sprays, perfume sprays. No, they're all external. So we will talk more about perfumes today, right? Flavors are similar, but the safety profile of flavors are different. And while a food flavor, like cherry or almond, can be used in a cream, usually for a food product, floral flavor and all those things are very rare, right? Anyway, now this is the difference. Flavor is for food. Perfume is for all products that are obtained, that are used externally, right? So now, perfume, I told you, it's not a single compound. It's a blend of so many compounds, right? Perfume design, right? We have seen perfume design, right? Much like a musical note, make up a song and various shades of color turn into painting, fragrance notes are necessary to make a perfume, right? So many fragrance notes combine to form a perfume which is given to us to be incorporated in the final cosmetic product. Overall, there are three note scales that, when blended together, create the perfume's fragrant accord. Each of these levels, however, has its own primary purpose. We will see what is it. So, a perfume which we use for personal care products is not a single ingredient. It is a blend of so many ingredients, perfume oils or perfumery compounds. So when you see perfume oils have three note scales. What are they? What are the three note scales, right? They are top notes, middle notes, and base notes. Top notes, middle notes and base notes. Top notes provide the first scent impression of a fragrance once it has been applied to the skin. They are usually more volatile aromas that evaporate readily. They tend to be light, fresh, uplifting in nature and are generally not very expensive. Their scent usually lasts for 5 to 30 minutes. Lasts for about 5 to 30 minutes. Right? So, when you smell the perfume, you get the top note. You get the top note. Middle notes, sometimes referred to as heart notes of fragrances, make up the body of the blend. The smells of the middle note are not always immediately evident and may take 10 to 30 minutes to fully develop on the skin. They are the notes that classify the fragrance family and normally warm and soft. Right? That is the middle note. Base note are those with the greatest heavy weight. These scent notes are normally intense and heavy. They are intense and heavy. They are relaxing in nature and also most expensive of all oils. They last the longest and help to slow down the evaporation notes of the lighter note, giving the fragrance the holding power. What the base note does? The base notes hold the top and middle notes in the blend and release it accordingly, right? So, base notes, the compounds are very, very expensive. Middle notes is the heart, right? Top notes, it's also the important note because it is the first impression of the product you get when you just smell it. It's the top note which comes. That is also very important. But the most important thing here is, you say top note, middle note and base note, and when you use a perfume, it has to blend top note, middle notes and base notes. It's not that every few minutes, first 5 to 30 minutes the product smells something, after that the product smells something, no, after 1 hour the product smells different, no, it is not like that. See, you will see that the smell, it blends. Even though top notes come first, middle notes, base notes, no, you don't see the transition. You don't feel the transition. That is the perfumery art. No, it is the ART, art of perfumery. That's the art of perfumery. How you get the unique note by blending top notes, middle notes and bottom notes. But yet, it should not be three different perfumes to the consumer after a certain time when they apply on the hand. It has to be like the seven notes of the music. They blend together to get a song. That's how these notes blend together for a perfume. Right? That is the thing for learning. This is the thing. Top note comes first, middle notes, then base note stays for long. Right? We go individually. Top notes. Right? Top notes, also referred to as the opening notes or head note. The top notes of the fragrance are generally the lightest of all the notes. They are recognized immediately upon application of the perfume. The top notes are also the first fade given their light molecular structure, but this does not mean they aren't of utmost importance. They are very, very important. Very important, right? Note. Very important note. The top note of the fragrance represents the first impression to the consumer. How many times we have smelled the bottle and either selected it or rejected it? Because top notes didn't make a lasting impression on you, you reject. It's hugely important that top notes not only succeed at luring you in, but also smoothly transition into the heart of fragrance. This is very important. Smoothly transition into heart of fragrance. It is not that top note is there and suddenly after some time some other note comes. The consumer should, it's a very subtle transition from the top note to the middle note to the bottom note. This, the transition is very subtle. You will not know that it has moved from top note. It's very smooth transition from to the heart of the fragrance. Heart of the fragrance is the middle note, right? Common fragrance top notes includes lemon, orange, bergamot, grape, berries, and some of the herbs, lavender, right? Examples of top note. It's a huge list, but these are all examples of top note. Then middle notes. The middle notes or the heart notes make an appearance on the top notes. Once the top note evaporates, the middle notes are considered heart of the fragrance. They last longer than the top notes and having strong influence on the base notes to come. Again, from when the middle note goes and the base note comes, the transition should be always smooth there. A perfume's heart is generally pleasant and well-rounded. It's often a smooth combination of floral or fruit tones, sometimes infused with spices like cinnamon, nutmeg or cardamom, right? Common fragrances in the middle notes include geranium, rose, lemongrass, lang lang, lavender, coriander, nutmeg, neroli, jasmine. So these are all the middle notes. Based on the perfume characteristics, no, these are all examples. The middle notes are selected, right? The base note. So the base note, right? The base notes are the final fragrance notes that appear once the top notes are completely evaporated. The base notes mingle with the heart notes to create the full body of the fragrance, but are typically associated with dry down period. The job of the base note is to provide the lasting impression, right? These often rich notes linger on the skin for hours after the top notes and the middle notes have dissipated, has gone. Common fragrance in the base notes are cedarwood, sandalwood, vanilla, amber, patchouli, oak moss, musk. Okay. Without the combination of the three levels of notes, a fragrance just wouldn't be aromatically appealing. But together, they create beautiful scents. Together, they create beautiful scents. So now, pictorially, this is how. These are top notes, heart notes and base notes, right? This is how citrus herbs, flowers, green fruit, spices and woods and balsam and musk also comes in the base note, right? These are all, this is a pictorial representation of top notes, heart notes and the middle notes. we will get into some of the examples of aromatic ingredients which goes in each. See, top notes, these are all top notes. What are the green which has the smell of crushed leaves, sliced cucumber, green melon, violet leaves, true to nature, these are all class of green. Aldehydic, waxy, fatty, sparkling, peeled orange, etc. Fruity, peach, pineapple, apple, berries, fruity jasmine, fruity marigold, melon, etc. These are all the notes, description. Citrus, orange, lemon, lime, bergamot, grapefruit, tangerine, etc. So, some of the examples of top notes. Some of the examples of middle notes, right? Middle notes. Forest class, right? Pine, evergreen, conifer, fallen leaves, spicy, clove, cinnamon, nutmeg, pepper, floral, rose, jasmine, carnation, lily of the valley, honeysuckle, lilac. Then herbaceous, lavender, rosemary, sage, eucalyptus, thyme, coriander, mint, spearmint, peppermint, wintergreen, cooling menthol, etc. These are examples of middle notes, right? Whatever I am telling you, they are all examples. These are all type of middle notes. And the base notes, right? These are all whatever we saw was middle notes before. Okay. Now, the base notes, right? Base notes, woody, cedar, sandalwood, patchouli, vetiver, mossy, animal, civet, ambergris, leather class, fresh leather, new car smell, musks, then amber, vanilla, benzoin, myrrh, etc. So, these are all the examples of base notes, right? Examples of base notes, right? And there are some new notes which are new trends coming. Chocolate chip, lemon pie, sugar cookie, apple pie, German chocolate, then marine, ocean, air, fresh air, ozone, clean. These are all the new trends which are coming in the odor classification, right? Now, this is how the perfume is made, okay? This is how the perfume has three notes, and it is art and a science. The perfumers in companies like Givaudan, Roar, and big companies, perfumers are the highly paid person. They are the experts, right? And they deal with thousands and thousands of perfumery ingredients and the extracts. So it is an art which you have to develop. And typically how you describe a perfume, see an example, right? Marc Jacobs Daisy Cream UD Toilette is a sophisticated yet fresh scent. This is a perfume description, right? Perfume description. So, sophisticated yet scent created by master perfumer. Opening with juicy notes of blackberry, grapefruit and pear, the perfume flows into delicate bouquet of jasmine, wisteria and daisy, before settling onto a creamy base of coconut, white wood and musk. This is how the perfume is explained. Capturing the whimsical essence of a blooming meadow, Daisy Dream is light, soft scent that's perfect for daytime, housed in an elegant glass bottle adorned with daisies, right? Top notes, blackberry, grapefruit, pear. Heart notes, jasmine, lychee, blue, wisteria. Base notes, white woods, musk, coconut water. It's not actually, that is the, they would have obtained the smells by ingredients, but they say, what is the note like? Right? So, how this perfume description helps? Right? Perfume description is very, very important, because when you get a perfume, this perfume description is important to develop an advertisement. Right? See, when you smell the perfume, you get a little fresh, the little soap, fresh smell and a clean smell. That is why the taking bath in a waterfall and all those things, no, it has to, it, no, if it is a fruity smell and it's a the ad is more on a floral thing, it doesn't match. So a green perfume, no, which gives a green leafy perfume, it has to be in the woods, no, in a forest with dry leaves, walking on the dry leaves, that such experiences. So the fragrance and how you communicate to the consumers, no, it depends of, it's very, very important on the communication angle. And we will come to the next aspect of why the fragrance is, description is important little later. Now, perfume and regulatory. Okay, International Fragrance Association, IFRA, they have a guideline. Your fragrance should be safe as per IFRA guidelines. So, the perfume supplier should give a certification on this, right? When you get a perfume from a supplier, perfume supplier, you have to get this certification on adherence to IFRA guidelines, right? And the next one is perfume regulatory, right? Regulatory. Now, European Union regulation, right? Annex 3, list of substances which cosmetic products must not contain except subject to the restrictions laid down. Okay, ingredient reference number 67 to 92 are mostly ingredients in perfumes, right? What they have done, they have specified that in the fragrance, in the final product, no, you are adding 0.5% of the fragrance in the product, and in the final product, if the level of those ingredients are above this percent, that ingredient should be labeled on the product label, right? It should be mentioned on the product label. I will show you an example. For example, this is how. There are a lot of ingredients. For example, citronellol, right? The presence of the substance must be indicated in the list of ingredients when it concentration exceeds 0.001% in leave-on products and 0.01% in the rinse off products, right? So limonin, same way limonin, hexyl cinnamol, like this, there are list of ingredients given. So what happens, no, when you get the perfume from the supplier, you have to get, this is called the allergen list, EU allergen list for perfume. You have to get the supplier certification that I am going, if you say that I am going to use this perfume at 0.7% in my final product, what are the ingredients from the perfume, allergens in the perfume that I have to list on the label, because the composition of the perfume is very secret and it only the perfumers and the perfumery company knows that, no? And very rarely they open to some companies like Procter & Gamble and Unilever, some companies where under confidentiality agreement they open it to the safety department of the companies to ensure again that everything is safe. But generally they don't give the composition, but they will give the detail, that certification, that it is according to the IFRA guidelines, that if you use at this percentage, these are the allergens that you have to list on the label. So they will give those things. So you have to get those certifications also on the thing is on see, it's annex 3, it's in the annex 3 of EU guidelines on cosmetics, right? So this is the one which you have to take care. So perfume and perfume in perfume description. Why perfume description is important? Because it is very, very important, because during product design itself, you have to see for what product you are going to use, what you want to communicate to the consumers from the product, right? If you want to denote freshness, you might use some sort of notes. If you want to denote nourishment, right, you will have some notes. And also, what is your brand? Okay, I might have different characteristics of perfume for a Lifebuoy soap, different characteristics of a perfume for Lux soap, different characteristics of perfume for Pond's brand, different characteristics of perfume for a Lakme brand, no? So it all depends, no? And the application and so designing the perfume for a product, it's a close interaction between the R&D marketing of the company and the perfumery houses, no? All three have to work together to get the perfume. And perfume and product interaction, this is very, very important. So the perfumery houses should know for what product you are going to use the product, then the perfume, right? See, a perfume, it smells with particular character in a shampoo might smell totally different in a cream. Because again, the perfumery in the top note, middle note, those partition, no? The partition between oil, water, surfactants, those things changes when the base is changed. In a 100% water surfactant base like shampoos, the partition is different. When it is an oil in water emulsion, the thing is different. When an oil in water emulsion, it's a different. So you have to be very, very careful. That is why some companies try to have same perfume for all the range of products, which it's a little tricky, because the perfume smells differently in different base, right? So perfume product interaction, and this is very, very important. Now this is what I want to tell you about perfumes. But next session, we will talk about perfume brief. What is a perfume brief? Because the marketing, R&D and the perfume houses have to sit together, and actually the company should issue a perfume, the product manufacturing company should issue a perfume brief to the perfumery houses initially, because perfumery houses have to be very clear on what they want No? So, for that, we have to give details to the perfumery company. And what are those details which we have to give? I will list out those details, right, in the next section, next part, right? It's again, it might be a 15, more than 20, 25 minutes video, but here each and every video is getting extended. So I want to show this to you, perfume, and there are various perfumes are classified according to their smell, right? It can be floral, fruity, you know, then bouquet, that is a group of flowers, then woody, like sandalwood, patchouli, then musky, civet, green, spicy, no? So you can classify in that way also. That comes in the top note, middle notes and bottom notes I have given. You can take some of those classification. But a perfume, the most important thing is top, middle and bottom note. Top, heart and the bottom notes. And the entire art of perfumery is how to blend these three notes together to give a perfume, right? Thank you. Thank you. This is what I would like to share to you all about perfume. And perfume and perfumery is it's a big topic. There are institutions which on perfume on taste, right? They have a institute, right? In France and some of the countries, they have an institute on perfumery. So, and some of the companies in India also, they run classes on perfumery, right? So, perfumery is a perfume and perfumers, it's a big art, big science, interesting. So, if you have passion to that art and your nose is strong, no? Why not? Thank you. The next thing, I end with my life lesson. Today, part 21, the life lesson, in a group, one person balances the weakness of others. Right? So, everybody has strength and weaknesses. So, when there is a teamwork, one person balances the weakness of the other. So, in a team, the group performs better than trying to do individually, right? This is what one lesson I learned. So, in a group, one person balances the weakness of others so that the output is great. Thank you. Thank you for listening to me today. Thank you. Bye.